Herzlich willkommen zum IBC Report 2014 von digitalschnitt.de Magic Multimedia.
Wie heißt es so schön, auf der NAB-Show ankündigen und dann zur IBC-Show oder zur IBC ausliefern. Und das war auch der Plan für den Shogun. Das war angekündigt, so etwa Ende des Jahres wird er kommen. Bei mir steht jetzt Jeremy von der Firma Atomos und ihn werde ich jetzt gleich zu den Details zu dem neuen 4K Field Recorder Shogun fragen. Und natürlich gleich die erste Frage. When will the Shogun be available?
Okay, so the Shogun will be available at the beginning of November. We've slipped a couple of weeks, but everything's under control now and we're in production. So, yeah, by the beginning of November, we believe everyone will have it in their hands. Yeah.
And do you show the Shogun as a final sample here on the show?
Yeah, it's exactly our production version. What isn't final is the firmware version. We've disabled the touch panel because there's still a few bugs in the panel, in that controller.
Can we take a look at the Shogun now?
Absolutely we can. Shall we?
Yes. So,
yeah, what we've got is our, you know, amazing 1920 1080 and 1200 screen. You can see down here there's a bit of a difference. We've got a black area, which is the extra 120 pixels we're using for a lot of the functions. And why that's important is it's getting rid of any clutter around and overlays required over the image. Obviously, we're coming in 4K from the A7S, and you can see we're displaying 4K 2398 on there. And I think probably you can see our tally light here just telling us that we're in operational mode waiting to record. We've included quite a few new features in terms of the operating system and the way it works.
Yeah.
And most of it is just bringing the settings into one menu structure with a window in the middle. You could go to our website and check out exactly how the GUI will work. Or I can show you that on my laptop, which is an emulator.
Yeah.
And very light, very portable. We've got two heat pipes at the top for dissipation of heat, which means that we know we can run up to higher data rates like 4KP60, for example, in the future.
Yeah. How do you handle power supply?
Okay, so there's one battery on the back of the unit, but we've also just come to market with a pretty cool little product called the Power Station. Mm-hmm. It takes our patented continuous battery system.
Yeah.
One battery goes down, switches to the other side, you replace this one. We've got three DC outs. One with a splitter and one down here, so two, three DC outs.
Okay.
And you power your camera, monitor recorder, and your lighting all from here. It goes up to 48 watts of draw, 5 amps per output. And input is directly from the mains. We'll charge these batteries. There's an internal charger. We'll charge these batteries in around 2 hours. So two batteries, 1 hour each.
And this is available?
This is available at the same time as Shogun.
Okay.
So with this combination, any camera gets continuous power. There's so many problems on the set with batteries.
Yeah.
So we're trying to simplify it, bring a power management solution, and this can go anywhere. We've got LEDs indicating at the front and screw threads top and bottom from easy mounting with cameras.
And I've seen you have USB connection, so I easily can also load my mobile phone.
Absolutely,
which,
and it does 2 amps for your tablets.
Yeah. Oh.
So 2 amp on one USB or 1 amp each one.
Mm-hmm. But back to the Shogun. Mm. The typical recording functionalities, the formats you can record. Can you tell us a little bit about this?
Yeah, so you can record 4K ProRes, Apple ProRes 422 10-bit, which goes very nicely with the new FS7. And that combination, I believe, is killer. You've got Cinema DNG RAW. These are all up to 30p to start with.
Yeah.
Later on, we'll do a 60p update.
Oh, okay.
We've announced that already.
Yeah.
And the other format we record is Avid DNX. HD, but only in HD formats.
Yeah.
But we will be able to crank that up to like 120 frames a second HD.
Oh, really? Okay. And For the RAW formats, what are the plans to support different kinds of RAW formats in the market?
C500, we're supporting that. There's a couple of other companies that have given us, that I can't announce yet, that have given us their RAW specification, which means we can then work to implement that.
So you're planning to be a D4K record on the market?
Absolutely. The 4K recorder. We've got 3D LUTs, calibrated screen, best screen in the industry, recording the highest quality formats at the fastest frame rates from the current cameras today. A7S, GH4, FS700, and the new FS7 are our go-to 4K cameras.
And may I ask you, well, the Shogun is so great, the display is fantastic, and it's able, of course, to record even HD.
Yes.
What will happen to Ninja and Samurai Blade?
Well, it's still a $2,000 product.
Okay.
You know, they're $1,000. It's half the price. If you're just doing HD, then you don't need, if you don't need 5060p HD, then the Ninja Star, Ninja Blade, and Samurai Blade are perfect solutions for the customer. And I think when you look at how long you're going to be using it for, which is a couple of years, 1 to 2 years minimum, then $1,000 is going to save you, you know, a lot of money. And so I believe that it's the same PPI, right? It's the same pixels per square inch.
Yeah.
I mean, this is a better panel because it's 1920 1200 in a 7-inch.
Yeah.
So yeah, I think we're in a good position to keep offering these amazing displays to people, and the price difference will dictate whether the Shogun just swallows everything else.
Okay. So you're able to really offer different solutions for different kinds of customers.
Yes.
And this is, yeah, the big Shogun,
the big
master
daddy.
Fighter.
That's right. He's the big daddy who trains the samurais.
Ah, okay. So Jeremy, thank you very much for giving us a very good and nice impression of the Shogun. And we're looking forward to sell them soon. Thank you very much.
Thank you.